The Cat of Dovrefjell. There once was a man up in Finnmark who had caught a great white bear, and he was going down to the king of Denmark with it. As it happened, he came to Dovrefjell on Christmas Eve, and he came to the cottage of a man named Halvor. He asked if he and his bear could spend the night. "Dear me," said Halvor, "we have no room to offer anyone now, because every Christmas Eve so many trolls descend upon us that we have to take our leave of the house, so we don't even have a roof over our own heads." "Oh, you might let us spend the night still," said the man. "My bear can sleep under the stove there, and I can sleep in the side room." He kept asking for so long that in the end he was allowed to stay. Then the people left the house, having set the table for the trolls with sour cream porridge, lutefisk and sausage, and every other good food, as if to any other guests they would have at table. It wasn't long until the trolls came knocking. Some were large, some were small, some had long tails, and others had no tail at all. And some had long, long noses. And then they ate and drank and tasted every dish. But then one of the troll children caught sight of the white bear under the stove. So he took a piece of sausage on his fork, warmed it by the fire, before placing it in front of the bear's nose. The sausage was so hot it burned him, so the white bear leapt up, roared, and chased everyone out of the house, both big and small. The next year, Halvor was out in the afternoon of Christmas Eve getting some wood for the weekend, for he was expecting the trolls again. He was hard at work chopping when he heard from the wood, "Halvor! Halvor!" "Yes," he answered. "Do you still have that large cat of yours?" "Yes, she sleeps under the stove," Halvor replied. "And that's not all. Now she's got 7 kittens as well, and they are much larger and fiercer than she is." "Then we're never coming back to your place," the troll shouted from the woods. And since that time, the trolls have not eaten Christmas porridge at Halvor's on Dovrefjell.